Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Pradhan, for giving me this opportunity and a brief about me. So I don't think I need to introduce myself. Just on the thought, you know, what Mr. Khanjlia has just said, that there's a huge gap in supply and demand. Almost, you know, 50% of our, you know, water is flowing freely, and we don't have any storage. Storage is a big issue and challenges. We have challenges of building some more storage space in the country. So with this presentation, I'm going to talk about some new paradigm for shift, specially focused towards urban water supply infrastructure, and how things going to help. As you see in our system, we have a very linear approach. Like, we use it and then we just throw it. We don't grab it, actually. So maybe with this presentation, we have a thought, you know, how you can move across into a circular motion by recycle, reuse of, you know, water. So as we see the past trends, you know, the focus of water utilities was more towards, you know, public health and protection of drinking water sources, and we had free flow of water. But with the urbanizations, we have a challenges, you know, maintaining this, you know, linear solutions, free flow of water, and there are a lot of issues in terms of, you know, space, and then you have financial constraint. So with this, you know, the future of water would be like, I would say, there are mega cities which are emerging, which requires a lot of water. There's a climate variability, so water economics is changing. So when we say in terms of pricing, when we go for cell phone top-off, we are happy to pay for cell phone top-off, anybody. But when we go to buy some water, or when we want water, we don't want to pay. Even governments, you know, they want to subsidize water as much as possible due to various reasons. But I think there's a need, you know, to make water, you know, bring some pricing level to this from the utility side. You know, they should get money, actually. Then there's a technology which has issues. There are emerging technologies like sensors and data which are coming. So how these challenges can be met? The solution number one, as Dr. Pradhan just said, like, we work together on integrated water resource management project, where, you know, you have to think about all the sources of water, whether it is surface water, groundwater, or your treated wastewater. I would say the entire cycle need to be, I would say, integrated when you're planning any city. Non-revenue water is a major challenge these days, because there's a big challenge for the utilities. We have almost 40 to 50% of leakage into the system, and there's a difficulty in collecting revenue from the utilities. If you go for privatization, even private sector has challenges, you know, to get a revenue model, right revenue model in the cities. So recycle reuse is one of the, you know, focus area with this presentation, where we can, you know, think about direct or indirect solutions. There are implementation challenges where right project consultants are not existing, where people have issues, social issues. There's a decreasing opportunities for changes in the on the social front. Our utilities are functioning with a traditional approach. We are not following program management kind of approach, where you see sustainability for the next 30 to 50 years. So I'll give you some examples as we go along, how program management approach going to help into managing your water sources. There are various form of PPP and infrastructure delivery models are available. Some of the companies, maybe some of you are present here, they are working in this area, PPP infrastructure, but yes, they are facing challenges on various fronts. And you do need political will and leadership skills. And with this, I'll give an example of Singapore as we go along, how political wills happen, makes changes into their systems, you know. Then public engagement and education is very, very important if we are going for direct use of water. So recycle reuse can be for drinking or non-drinking. There are new emergence of water technologies. The cost of treatment of water bringing to indirect or portable use or direct portable is going down from the last 20 years as technologies are emerging. There are smart technologies which are coming up, you know, which have more efficiencies into the system. So let's think about situation, you know, when we had a linear solutions, we used to grab it, use it, and throw it. And those were the days when, you know, the population was 2 billion. Now the situation has come up, you know, we have to move towards circular solutions. We need to collect every drop of water and use and reuse it more than once, and maybe multiple times, actually, as much as possible. So there are three areas which makes things successful, like water infrastructure and management, strong governance, and engaged communities. All these three areas need to be focused when you go along, you know, recycle and reuse of water. And there are all these three clusters. We have 9 attributes, you know, to assess the performance of any water sector, like, say, like adequacy of your water resources, infrastructure stability, operation optimization, which Dr. Pradhan just said, capacity and leadership development, very important. The traditional approach needs to be changed. You need a good leader to manage your utilities. Financial viability is very, very important in India. We have a least cost system here, so we have to be very careful, but the least cost solution should be sustainable here. Sector resilience and adaptability, community sustainability, stakeholders' engagement, service delivery, and customer satisfaction. So all these 9 areas, attributes need to be recognized as we go along into systems performance. One of the examples in the next few slides, I'm going to talk about Singapore, where I have worked actually personally, and I have trained many state government organizations there, you know, taking them to Singapore, what they have done, how they have done. And the reason behind is, you know, we share similar kind of, you know, topography and climate, and sort of there is a culture is almost same in Singapore or India. But yes, the thinking process can be different, you know, on leadership front. So the recycle reuse program started in 1970 in Singapore. And the relationship between Malaysia is a bit, you know, very, not very strong in terms of sharing water resources of Singapore. So they launched their new water program, like what they saw, you know, in early, in late 90s, that they had an issue of, you know, water sustainability for the next 50 years with the water sharing agreement they had with Malaysia. So they gave a very long-term thinking process, like, let's explore solution within their country. The area is very small. So they launched a new water launch program, which is sort of, you know, collecting every drop of water within their land and reuse it more than once. That's what they did. And currently, with this approach, in the next 15 years, today, they are meeting more than 30% of their demand by using this recycled, reuse new water. And they are aiming to do 60% by in the next 15 years, I would say. So they are having more new higher technology plants which are going to come up, and 60% of the Singapore demand will be through recycled reuse, which is very good achievement, I would say. So primarily, the 30% water, they are using it for industrial application and indirect drinking use. So what I mean to say, they are mixing the new water, treated water, blending with their reservoirs, and then they're treating it for drinking. That's how they're doing. And their new water has more than 60 water quality parameters, which no utilities is monitoring. They are monitoring 60 parameters when they're using their new water. So, which is, I would say, one of the best practices they are following in the world. And they have a very successful, you know, public assessment and education program, and it started from their prime minister, actually. When new water started, the prime minister of Singapore drank the first drop of that water, so that public can drink it. So some of the steps which Singapore had taken, like most of the water came from Malaysia, which was the main source. Then they developed their water and wastewater treatment plants. Then they provided some, you know, local themes to use their water. Then they diversified with more source of water. Like, they had now 4 national taps, which are managed by one single utilities. Then they unified all their agencies. Like they had earlier three agencies working, managing their water. Now there's only one agency, PUB Singapore, which is managing their water. Like it can be, I would say, that would be future of any utilities in Indian cities. Like only one single agency should manage their water, whether it is, I would say, rainwater, drainage, or surface water, groundwater, or wastewater treatment. I think that should be one of the initiatives which we must think about, that in Indian city, is it possible to have one agency to manage the water? Then they develop a national theme during that period. And besides this, in their policy, any policy in Singapore, you will see it is dominated by water. Water is water. Every other policy had to bend their knees to the water. Whether it is industrial policy, any investment policy, or any development policy, water is the first line. Do they have water? So that's their objective in every policy. So the integrated approach, as I just said, they integrated all the three agencies into one. Water, drainage, and sanitation is managed by one single agency in Singapore. That's how they are managing their assets, and it is controlled by agencies. They have all the reservoirs, treatment plants, water recycling plants, all are managed in 100% by one agencies. So some of the technologies which they are following, what they are doing, they are doing microfiltration and ultrafiltration, followed by reverse osmosis and ultraviolet and disinfection. And that's the kind of water they are getting. In fact, when I go to Singapore, I drank this water many times. So they have very large-scale water recycling plant and under three format: non-drinking water reuse, direct drinking water reuse, indirect drinking water reuse. So the middle one, direct drinking water use, they are still not following, but they are going to come up with this drinking water use. So some of the basic definition, water use, I think most of us are from water side. I don't need to speak on this. What is indirect potable use? What is direct potable use? I think many of us are aware of this. Through this diagram, you know, you can imagine this incidental and unplanned direct potable use. This is what actually happening in our cities. What you see from this diagram, you have city one where you have a wastewater treatment plant and we are disposing it in our river. Then we have another city on downstream side. They are pumping the same water and they are putting it for drinking. Actually, this is what happening when we have unplanned direct, and many for in our city it is happening. So I would say recycling and reuse is nothing new for our systems. It is already existing in our system. Only thing, we need to check the water quality, what kind of water is coming. And with this, Delhi is facing from the last 3 months, there is a challenge of nutrients or ammonia in the water. And from the DJB Twitter and the newspaper, so in the last 3 months I've been reading, there's a high ammonia content they are getting because of Haryana is not treating their wastewater properly. So their plants are failing, their filtration units are failing. So that's the challenge which they are facing, because they expected the water, raw water which they are getting and the technology which they are using is sufficient enough to manage the river water, which are designed based upon river water, raw water quality, but it's not capable of managing the wastewater which is entering from other cities. So that's a challenge which our cities are facing, and Delhi itself is facing these days. So the concept for indirect potable use, you have advanced wastewater treatment facilities, which goes to water resource. Then we have water treatment facilities, which treats the water to a drinkable level. That's a concept at the moment. Singapore has, instead of surface water, they have a reservoir actually, which they store and then they send it to their water treatment plant and treat it for the domestic water supply. That's how they are managing at the moment. Direct potable reuse is...